if you play basketball, your ultimate goal is to make it to the NBA. So like, if you're not working towards that goal, then you basically should not even be playing. So I have a lot to like improve on and stuff like that. So every day I'm just here working. Like, I know my ultimate goal is to make it like to the big league. So that's my motivation here every day.
It ain't burning. We ain't doing it right.
Yep, next thing we're doing is this.
I'm trying to learn from him.
You got it.
He done played for 9 years. 9 years in the NBA. He the man around here. I'm like a little mosquito just sucking in all the blood, trying to get.
I'll come here in the morning, do some speed and agility stuff and like a little weightlifting and stuff like that. Then I'll get a little breakfast maybe. And then with me and Marcus will do some on the court workouts for like an hour and a half.
Hey, hold up.
Hey, get up versus them today.
They disrespecting the game.
You guys like you can't move in them. You can't move.
My name is Marcus Benitez. Beans is what they call me. That's my nickname. All I want to do is just have him, you know, to prolong his year, his basketball career, play, you know, as much as possible. Just helping him to maximize his potential and do what the best he can do for his career that he loves to do, which is playing basketball.
This past year, I just had to get back into that confident, you know, that groove of being a point guard. So me and Marcus, he been working on just like, you know, like making good passes and like just being a leader, like being vocal and stuff. So while I'm out there working, I need to be talking, you know, and encouraging others, you know, just little things like that, that point guards need to be successful.
I'm telling you,
This year was a challenging year for me because I was away from home, so like I just had to like kind of grow up more, even more, and you know why I'm over there. You know, like I'm over there to handle business because we're overseas. Like you have a few bad games, like they may send you home, so you have to know like this is what I'm focusing on. Like I can't be worried about what my family doing back home. Like I need to focus on myself because this is my future and this is what I want to do. So it taught me, it made me be a man. It's no shortcuts to like being a Division I college player. Like I had to take a different route. So like my coming out of high school, I went to junior college. You kind of have like a little doubt or like a little frustration, like you think you're a D1 player, or but college coach is not recruiting you as a D1 player and stuff. So you just gotta like go to another level of focus. Like this is what I really want to do. So all the other stuff can wait, like all the partying and just like playing around, playing video games, like all that can wait, like if you're really serious about, you know, making D1. For me, I would just tell like people back home, like know what your goal is and know that you have to like be extremely focused, because one bad mistake, you can like crush your dream. So that's for me, like I know like if I'm in a bad situation or something, like I'm not gonna do anything to mess up my dream. Like I done got far enough to like turn back. So also kids in school, like grades, like that was a big reason why I got a chance to go to Division I, because I handled my grades in junior college and I was able to leave after 1 year. So that was the biggest thing for me, was grades and my work ethic. I feel like I don't supposed to be in the position I'm in today. Where I come from, it's just like a lot of people don't make it out. So, but I was blessed, like I was fortunate to, you know, my dad sent me to private school. So I feel like that helped me like out tremendously. So, but I don't know where I would be if I didn't go to private school. So that's what I would say. Like a lot of people prayed for me that I made it out. Like I know I had a lot of people back home like rooting for me and stuff. So it was kind of like motivation, like I can't let them down. So that's one thing I would say like people don't know about.